It is time to show off the Bafang M625. This is a great DIY kit if you want to build your own electric bike, like this one that I call the P61 Black Widow. I am auctioning off starting at $1. Wow! How fast does it go? So let's get that right out of the way and see how fast will this 1,000-watt mid-drive motor propel this very sleek, retro-styled electric bike. I went all out and spared no expense, starting with the 26-inch Michelin Pilot tires. Yes, I just had to go with something that had Pilot on it because it fits with the overall theme, named after, of course, the aircraft. Reasonably flat stretch of road. All right, top gear and pedaling. 25, 26, 27, 28, 30, 31. 33, 34, 35. We're doing 35. I got a little more of a run up that time, passing the camera at 36. So that was really, really smooth. I'm gonna give some credit to the tires here because normally, here we go, we're testing out fat bikes with 1,000-watt mid-drive motors. And this, I've got 26-inch skinny tires, really good road tread. I'm doing a slight uphill right now, 20, 25, 26 miles an hour. So this bike moves along quite nicely. This is a CANBUS version of the motor, the new Bafang M625. Which means you can't change or adjust as many things as you could on the older BBSHD. But thankfully, you can still remove the speed limit.
Atomic batteries to power, turbines to speed.
There is one thing that the display does that's a little bit different, however, so I'll pull over and show that to you guys. All right, speed limit. See what happens when you press on that to change it? You get this warning. It says, thank you for using Bafang products. When using or modifying parameters, please make sure to comply with the local laws and regulations. And then you have to hit either consent or cancel. I guess that's their way of saying, it's not our responsibility at this point. You need to make sure you have the speed limit set correctly for your local laws and you agreed to it. I'm kind of in the middle of the gear range, and if I give it some throttle, off we go. So not even the highest gear. Here's our speed going down this hill. You can see I'm getting up to speed, no problem. I've got a lot of gears left I could be using to go even faster. Very stable, no hands. Over 30 miles an hour, tracking nice and true. Bike handles really nice on the road. And if we want to go uphill, we're going up a gradual hill here. 15, 16 miles an hour, we're still accelerating. 17, 18, not bad at all. I built this bike before we had the massive 246mm rotors in stock. So these are running some more standard thickness 203s with red Juintec hydraulic brakes. I did add my own brake switches to these because it's not something that they normally come with. The other thing that's new is this. The battery is now kind of available as a package deal with the motor. And there's good and bad to that. I think the good thing is that you can now buy a complete package. Otherwise, people were always looking for their own batteries, trying to wire up connectors. Whereas this kit and this battery were all plug and play with each other. I just had to find a bike then to put them on. BTN, one of the manufacturers overseas, hooked me up with this motor from Bafang and asked me to do a review on the motor and actually build a bike with it. I decided I wanted to do something completely custom, and I had this frame sitting around. I've got a huge suspension fork on there that, although way overkill, it's nice. I wanted something where you could be cruising along at 30 miles an hour, hit a pothole, and it doesn't matter. Obviously, the saddle doesn't have as much cushion to it as other bike saddles would. But it gets the job done. You have a lot of movement that you can use back and forth. It also has these bolts. You can move the saddle up and down. So if you were shorter, you could scoot that down. If you want to move it up all the way to the max, you can. I kind of have it set there because it gives the overall bike a certain look. I'm running a SRAM 9-speed on the back. This is the same derailleur setup we're using on the Blackbird. How it mounts to the frame, however, is completely custom because this frame was really designed for more like a single speed setup. So definitely some modifications to the frame that had to happen there. One of the cool things about this motor kit is the lighting setup. Previous Bafang BBSHD setups were not set up for lights. You can see the little light symbol right there. If we hold that down for a few seconds, the display dims. There's a little light symbol up in the corner that turns on the brake light, which is not only a running light, but a functional brake light. And we've got power for a nice big headlight. But the motor kit already had the 2-pin waterproof connectors for the tail light and for the headlight. It was already part of the kit. Like I said, that's something brand new. So to me, that's a plus for these motors. Another plus for me is this chain ring. The BBSHD motors used to come with this like stamped chain ring, and the tooth profile was flat, basically meaning that each one of these teeth was exactly the same all the way around. They have upgraded these now, so you can see there's a little groove right here where the chain links set into. I'll see if I can get this on camera. So if you're looking top down at a chain, you'll see that the gap between this link and this link is wider and fatter. So what they've done is made the chain ring wider and fatter. It holds on to the chain a lot better, so you're not dropping it off. That's a problem I've seen on some of those originals if the bike wasn't set up quite right. The display itself is nice. It's easy to read. There's nothing particularly special about it versus older versions. You've got a big setting for miles per hour. There is a clock setting. Here you can see if you're in sport mode or eco mode. And then over here we've got our battery voltage, our trip distance, and then you've got this bar right here that runs down as you run the battery down. It may seem like a small thing, but I do like the throttle they're putting on there. That seems a lot beefier and stronger than the old little thumb throttles that used to come with the bikes. I forgot to mention on this battery, one was the capacity. This is a 19 amp hour, so pretty decent size. I think that's matched really well for a 1,000-watt motor. The other thing is they put a nice handle in the top of it. So when you unlock this, it's super easy to grab this handle, pop it off the cradle that's mounted to the bike and carry it inside. And speaking of cradles, it's really hard to tell because it's black, but the cradle that's mounted to the bike has a lot of holes in it, so really versatile on the mounting positions. But even better than that, probably my favorite thing about the battery is that the cradle isn't plastic. This piece you see right here, I'm guessing is aluminum. It could be magnesium or something similar, but it is actually definitely made out of metal. This is gonna hold up long-term really well. So if you like building your own custom bikes and you're worried about the new Bafang M625, is it just as good or any different than the old BBSHD? I would say the motor feels just as powerful as it was before. I personally can't tell any difference. The top speed on the bike certainly shows that it's got the power. You can unlock the speeds. The only thing that I haven't really dove into, which I'm suspecting could be a problem, is if you really like to fine-tune settings, you might be a little bit more restricted. But if you're happy with just the basic settings, what you can change on the display, the motor works great. Now, if you are not into DIY and building your own custom bikes, but you still want one, you can have this one. As of the launch of this very video, the auction for this bike is now live on our website. I will put a link in the description. So thanks again to Bafang for letting me install the motor on here. I want to reiterate that this is a one-off custom bike. I am not building another one like this ever again. I couldn't even if I wanted to. This frame doesn't exist anymore, and I think it has turned out really well. Once again, this is the custom P61 Black Widow. We did all of the assembly, modifications, everything right here in our facility in Grass Valley, California. I'm more than happy to answer any questions about this specific bike. I do have another video with a little bit more detail on some of the other specs of the bike. You can check that out right here.